Welcome to this new show, and today we have the honor to be with somebody who is actually making an impact in making things happen, in bringing projects together. Things that were not going to happen, they are actually making them happen. His name is Gary Nader. Did I pronounce that right?
Yeah, close enough.
It's close enough. He's a co-founder of ourcrowd.com, that is a company that actually works on crowdfunding. Thank you so much, Gary, being with us today.
My pleasure. Great. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, of course. So one of the things I was wondering is, like, you have been funding projects, making them a reality, and there are projects who do great and projects who actually don't work that well or don't even are, you know, they don't even start. So what did you see that are the differences between these projects?
Okay, so first of all, I mean, the main benefit of our platform is everything that we actually decided to post on the platform, once we make the decision to invest, all of them actually got funded. So we didn't have a case that the project got on the platform and did not get to the end. There's definitely cases in which the project goes faster or slower on the platform. And what we found out is that there are two main criteria that needs to be taken into account. One is the project needs to be very self-explanatory. I mean, the way we work is the investor makes a decision very quickly on whether they want to invest in the project or not, in addition to our decision. So we decided to invest, but then we post that on the site and we invite investors to join us. Some of them make the investment decision very quickly, in a matter of minutes, and it needs to be something that they can decide, that they can understand and decide very quickly. So so first of all, if it's too complex, if it's too technical, that might be a problem, or if it's actually something that it seems like many other people are doing also, maybe the company is doing it differently, etc. But if the initial impression is, we've seen this, you know, this is just like any other thing, that also doesn't work, okay? So that's one parameter. The second parameter that we saw is that if the project has some emotional attachment of the investor, they go faster. So not just the business, but also the desire of the investor to actually invest in this. So social impact, medical devices, things that have a little more than just the business, also go faster on the platform.
So you are saying, Guy, that when you see a connection from the founder, for example, that he had a health problem, he had a limitation, and was a challenge for him?
Exactly. I'll give you an example. I mean, one of our most successful projects so far, or the most successful, we invested actually three times in a company that created exoskeleton that allows paraplegic people to stand up and walk. So, and that was basically by a founder that got hit in a sport accident and lost the ability to walk. And basically, and he's a terrific engineer, so he created this unit that is. You know, holding the legs and allows him to stand up and walk. And you might have seen it even on TV. I mean, it was in Glee, one of the channels. And we actually not only funded that, but that was the first IPO of a company that got equity crowdfunding in it. They went public last September in New York, very successful company. And this is exactly the case in which, in addition to this being potentially a very good business, there's this emotional attachment, both of the entrepreneur and the story of the entrepreneur, but in general, investors like to invest in things that have impact beyond the financial impact. So that's a perfect example for a project that go very well on the platform.
So I see the concept of social, like making a difference, contributing in something, solving problems, they go far.
Yes. And for instance, we started actually a partnership with the Wharton Business School. They have a social venture fellow fund that invests in, that screens, and then we invested in social impact projects, and these are the most kind of perfect fit for the platform.
Great. So Gary, when I'm talking about the ingredients that make successful this cocktail, this food, this amazing company, what would you say that other ones you mentioned, like being clear, don't be similar to others, is anything else that you see that are fundamentals to make this like a success? Like, Can you think of any other?
I would say that, we look at the usual parameters that any VC would look. So the team, the market size, of course, the deal itself needs to be attractive on the financials, the financials of the company. So those are traditional things. I think that the two different ones are basically the simplicity of explanation and the attachment. That's the social kind of
attachment.
Personal attachment. Yeah.
So you mentioned that this one is the most successful one. The one. Mm-hmm. What would be other examples so people can see and have an idea of what are the more successful projects? What would be the second one that you found and is like, wow, also super powerful?
Yeah, well, we try not to play favors between the different portfolio companies. But I'll give you another example. I mean, we funded a company called MST that basically really sophisticated technology that that allows a surgeon to see, it's an arm with a camera that allows the surgeon to see what's going on when he makes the surgery on the screen, replacing a second person that held the camera. And the problem with the second person was that sometimes he hit the tissue and then the camera kind of got fuzzy and then he had to take it out and clean it, etc. And they came up with this really amazing technology that knows where to look based on where the tools of the surgeon is and how not to find the tissue, and it saves a lot of time and a lot of money for the surgery. And again, this is a great company on the financial side and the potential side, but people can relate to the need and can relate to the importance of that.
And the emotional part of visualizing the operation, like
exactly. I mean,
they can feel
there's a story that they can get attached to. It's not just looking at the financial of a company that does something maybe great, but there's some story that that they can that gets emotional.
Great. Mm-hmm. So, Gadi, when people are thinking about opening a company, creating something, they don't know what to do. So what could be some advice that you can give them, like some ideas to actually create that, make that happen? What could be some suggestions around that?
I would say two things. I mean, one is a team. I mean, you don't start a company by yourself. You need to find, and primarily because you can't do everything yourself, but also because you will need support, a group support. You need shrink sessions between the founders because sometimes will be very tough. Sometimes, if you're alone, you would give up. And you need a team of two or three or four people that are in there together. And that's the most important thing. The second is when you start something, you might have a great idea, market research. You need to make sure that you're not getting in love with the product and kind of ignoring that other people are already doing this. You need to really understand the landscape of what you're stepping into. Those, I think, are the two main points.
Very important. Now, the last thing is, like, now people are maybe looking for investing, opportunities, like, to get funded. So what would you say are the steps if they want to be in a crowdfunding platform? I know that you are very selective. Your platform is not for everybody. But if they want to be in a platform, what would you say are the steps? Because that myself, I have been thinking, oh my God, this project, I should do a crowdfunding because it's so great, so powerful. And I didn't actually did that because I was like, oh, how does it work? So for everybody, what would you say are the steps? Like 1, 2, 3, whatever the steps, so people can actually make that happen.
So there are two types of crowdfunding. I mean, there's what we do, which is equity crowdfunding. So we actually invest in a company and get shares, and then this can be applied to any company. There's another type of crowdfunding, which is basically a product crowdfunding. So if you have a product that you can give and you need money to create, and you can create that in 9 months, and then so you crowdfund the development of this by people that buy that for $50, $100, $250, and you have platforms of that, Kickstarter, Indiegogo, etc. So I'm talking about equity because we're not doing reward based, or we're not doing the product crowdfunding. I think the main thing is to understand that it's not enough just to post yourself on the platform. You need to, for a project to succeed on the platform itself needs to endorse it. So we do that for every deal that we do. So it's not, the platform is not open. You need to approach us. We will screen the project. We will decide if we want to invest our own money. And then when we post that, it's a much stronger message to the audience of investors that says, we decided to put our own money in and come and join us. And that's why we got 100% success of every project that we posted. It's not just we post and maybe they like it, maybe they're not, because of our commitment, because of our decision and our process and due diligence.
So then it's a success, yes or yes? It's like a 100% chance to succeed?
We don't promise that, but so far so good.
And then, but the steps that you would say, that you would recommend, like what could be step number one, step number two, in order so they get clear, they get a piece of paper and start. Step number one, okay, God is saying step number one, boom, step number two, thing. What are the, you know, some steps that you can say so they can apply to your platform, or if they don't qualify, they can go to other platforms? Okay. But what could be that? Because I think this is going to be very powerful, because many people are like, oh my God, how do I do it? So can you kind of guide them in that step?
Yeah, the two things that I think they need to have before they approach us is, one is a very crystal clear story. Okay, and again, if there's some emotional attachment, that's even better.
Very good.
The second is, there needs to be the beginning of a business. We're not funding projects at the idea stage. So if you just have an idea and it's seed, that's not for us. Mm-hmm. There are potentially other platforms for that, but there needs to be some, what we call the heartbeat of the project of the business, either downloads or initial business or something that you can come to us and say, it's not just their idea, it's starting to happen, and I need your support both financially and on the business side to make that happen. Those are the two things that I think they need to have in place.
So that's before mm-hmm. even thinking about applying to your platform. And now in general terms, about applying to any platform, like anyone, including yours, after that, what could be like creating a powerful video or creating a prototype, or what could be like, you know, these steps that you know and they don't know, and they are like, oh my God, what are the steps?
Yeah, so if they don't have a video, we create a great video. Wow. So video is definitely important. Uh-huh. If it's their video, it's better, both because